The Democratic Senate leadership has taken shape. With Harry Reid leaving in retirement, the Democrats picked New York Senator Chuck Schumer as the new Senate Minority Leader. Two prominent progressives are also now in positions of power. As expected, Massachusetts Senator Elizabeth Warren was bumped up to vice chair of the organization, and former presidential candidate Bernie Sanders is now in a newly formed, created position of outreach chairman. To talk more about the new leadership and what Senator Sanders can bring to all of this, I'm joined tonight by Mike Papantonio, Ring of Fire radio host and attorney and host of America's Lawyer, soon to air here on RT America. Mike, good to have you with us tonight. It would appear that Bernie Sanders is holding a lot of cards right now. Is this a move that Chuck Schumer just had to make? And is this a deal that was cut at the Democratic convention? What do you know?
Great point. The most obvious choice for a leadership position in the Senate for Bernie Sanders was Schumer's position. But here's the only problem I see. The Democratic Party thinks that they can use Bernie as this tool that they can simply pull out when they want to, put him on a stage when they want to. Sanders has got to have a far more important role here. Sanders has never been shy about calling out corporate Democrats, and they won't be happy with that. Schumer has repeatedly condemned regulations on Wall Street. He's against taxing trades and hedge funds. He wasn't in favor of raising taxes on the wealthy. He is merely a continuation of the old regime. The Democrats, no matter how bad they got trounced, still can't come to the reality that they needed to have a new plan, and the person for that new plan was Bernie Sanders. Putting him in outreach doesn't do it when Schumer's in charge.
It almost seems as if the Democrats are throwing Bernie Sanders a bone. That, okay, we really got to make these Sanders supporters happy over here, so we better put him on the leadership team. I would be bold enough to ask the Democrats tonight, who the hell is Elizabeth Warren? How many millions of dollars did she raise? How many millions of people votes did she get? I mean, how many primaries did she win? It almost seems, Mike, as if the Democrats are afraid to admit that Bernie Sanders is the most popular progressive in this country, and in a way, he is still a threat to the establishment, and that establishment is Schumer, who won the in-caucus election. I think it stinks, personally. I think the Democrats are gutless. Your thoughts?
Well, I mean, look, he didn't just get there. You had other Democrats that voted to say, yeah, he's our guy. Schumer is who we are. We are a Wall Street party now. We have nothing in common with the Rust Belt. We have nothing in common with all the Americans losing their jobs. We have nothing in common with the American working public. We are in our own little bubble in Washington, D.C. that goes as far, if you can imagine, Ed, of actually appointing Joe Manchin as communications committee head. This is a guy who was close to saying, I'm going to turn Republican if the Republicans take the Senate. Now, he denied saying that, but you know, I got to tell you something, it came from several different sources, but they put him in charge of communications. So what does the progressive arm hear? They hear Chuck Schumer's in charge, business as usual. We may as well have Hillary Clinton in charge. We have it as crazy as Joe Manchin in charge of communicating with us. Look, there was a huge mistake, and the reason the mistake took place is because the Democrats can never come to reality. They need a reality check.
I'm waiting for Chuck Schumer to put out a press release saying that Russia had nothing to do with these selections. I mean, I think that would be probably apropos at this point. All right, Mike, what about this talk about George Soros, that he is going to do everything he can to circumvent the Trump administration? Number one, how credible is it? How much of an impact can he have? And is it the right path to take?
Well, it's the right path to take if you had the right people involved. Ed, you've been there, you've covered politics for so long, you know the same thing I know. In Washington, D.C., there is a bubble. And the bubble has no connection whatsoever to the people that surprised the Clinton campaign when they voted for Donald Trump. There was a total disconnect. Soros, bless his heart, always gives big money to the Democrats. But what he fails to do is bring in a coalition of people that actually speak for the American public. And unfortunately, Soros is nothing changes with Soros. Nothing changes. He has the same game plan that he's used decade after decade, and nothing will change here. It has to be radical. There has to be a new restructure of the Democratic Party. And with people like that in charge, it won't happen.
The only Democrat that has awakened or gotten the attention of the middle of the country is Bernie Sanders, and this is almost a roadkill position as I see it. Yes. The Democrats are quickly the left coast and the East Coast, and anything in between just doesn't matter. Mike Papantonio, good to have you with us tonight. Appreciate your time.